Existing within every independent school I have ever known has been a service program. Students go out in the world and they give something of value to people or organizations that are in need. In this video, we're going to introduce you to a program that does something differently. At the Rivers School outside of Boston, Massachusetts, 10th graders participate in the RISE program. They go out in the world, they give something of value, yet they do so in a context that requires them to define themselves, to get to know their own dreams, what they care about, their strengths and weaknesses, and perhaps most consequentially, that requires them to step forward as leaders. We introduce you to the RISE program and its founding director, gcLi alumna, Kate Wade. Kate, you've been doing this wonderful work of building leadership through service and other things at Rivers.
Right now we're engaged in the launch of the RISE program, which stands for Reflection and Introspection for Service Education. And it's really exciting to see our students finding time in their schedules to follow a path that they've created themselves. We've really encouraged our sophomores, again, this is for a sophomore year, to pause and think about what areas in their lives and their communities perhaps need some support. And they're currently looking into that first stage of service learning, which is investigation. They're really thinking about who they are and what their strengths are, and trying to figure out what kind of work they may want to be engaged in. Because what we actually do is we follow them and support them through a year-long project, and it actually is exciting to see this this very first stage coming together. So it's really exciting to see how we're talking about service learning within the context of leadership. And it actually starts with this stage that was set by our leadership committee and Samantha Brennan. And we get to use this incredible curriculum that exists already within our school culture. We have a leadership statement. What is it? We ask our students to embody that statement, to be their best selves and positively influence others. And that sense of knowing yourself, right? You have to think about who you are first, in order to positively influence others. And the sense of influencing, we take it in the 10th grade to mean positively influencing your community. And so the bedrock of this, of the RISE program, is really founded in our leadership statement. And that connection, I don't know if you can see that at other places. And so they are using these leadership traits and qualities that were written back in 2009. They were, I would say, co-authored by our leadership committee in conjunction with focus groups that our faculty engaged in. And the leadership committee asked our teachers, what are the ways that you're teaching leadership outside of academics? What are the things that you're teaching outside of academics? More basically. And so we have these skills and these qualities, and some of them include empathy and resilience and communication skills, and to give the students an opportunity to make the connection between what it means to give of yourself to others, and also then see how that can be transformational for the self. To have then our students articulate that moment back to us, I think that was recently, that was a really exciting moment. We had our juniors speak to some of our 10th graders, and to hear some of the 11th graders now verbalizing their own experience. And what I learned about myself was, in my project, I realized that. So there's this a very deep sense of transformation for the student, and yet that's not rooted in that almost stereotypical self-absorbed, angsty adolescent way, but instead it's about what I learned from really sitting down with a person or a community and listening to that person's story and asking the question, you know, where can we help you? Do you need help? Sometimes just being in that moment is the transformation. Other times it's having some output or product that accompanies that moment of, wow, I am of value, I can contribute, I can be a member of this community. And it's really, I think, been pretty incredible to see what a 16-year-old is truly capable of doing. The headliner of last year's, for me, I thought was the story of students who were affected by gun violence. And we, in our early years of the program, the projects were smaller, and we weren't always seeing students trying to approach systemic change or have conversations with these bigger issues. And so this was one of those, this was a turning point, I think, where we had two students who actually were very affected by what happened in Sandy Hook and had family members who had been talking to them over the past couple of years about these issues, and they felt that this was sort of their moment to really interact with it in a personal way. And so they asked, we want to start a conversation, but we don't know where to go with this. And so with their advisor and with some of the members of their team, we created a plan. And again, we're following that the process, the five stages of service learning that Catherine Berger Kay has outlined, right, after they investigated and realized they wanted to do this this conversation or dialogue around gun violence and prevention, they then actually planned to talk to their representative. So we went to the State House and we met with Representative Linsky, who had in the works this bill for Massachusetts to reduce gun violence. And they sat there and they said, we care and we want to know, what can we do? And I think they were actually shocked when he sort of sat forward in his chair and he said, you know what? I really need your help, and this is what you can do. And he said, you need to write letters for me. You need to get everybody in your school to understand why this is important and what's at stake. And, you know, this is going to make a difference. And so to have these 16-year-olds who I don't know that they believed in themselves at that point, and then they realized, wait, not only can we do this, but we're being asked to do this. And that call to action was, I think, pivotal for them in both their development of their own identity as potentially civically engaged citizens, but also as leaders. And then to come back to Rivers and say, all right, folks, we're writing letters. They set up tables outside of the lunch area. They had copies of the bill so that folks who said, what do you mean? This is my amendment, right? That I have a right to carry. I have a right to, you know, why should I change what I do? Or why should I change what my family does? And they were educating our community about where the loose ends in the law were, and why it was something they cared about. And ultimately, they sent over 80 letters to state representatives in Massachusetts, and they got great feedback from Representative Lindsay's office. He, in fact, was able to speak to them and say, thank you, you did a great job. They passed the bill in Massachusetts, and these kids feel like at the age of 16, they changed something. And so tying that into the leadership growth, I don't know, you know, we just had to get out of their way. We had to allow them an opportunity to see in themselves the potential to affect positive change. And all of it, again, was rooted in our leadership statement of, you know, be your best self, but positively influence others.
That's a great story. And to me, what it really shows you and Rivers injecting voice and leadership and buy-in mm-hmm. into service education.
Mm-hmm.
So that it's not just that the school has already set up these mechanisms for you to go out and do good things. It's going to the student, it sounds like, and saying, what really matters to you?
If you think about 10th grade, how often are these kids asked to be autonomous, independent thinkers and have no stakes attached to that and have no expectation of a specific output? I think you go back to the DEEC model, the IPO model. We're thinking about the processing that our kids are asked to do. We're thinking about how little sleep they're getting, and ultimately, in our school culture, as great as our school is, we still have these sophomores who are being evaluated at every turn. And so taking the grading off and taking the parents, really helping them see that they're on the sidelines, that they're not driving these projects, and providing a space for students to come into their own and have that voice, as you said, I think that was critical. I think that the second part of it was allowing them to fail. We've had these projects that haven't worked, and so the fact is they know it's a high stakes game. They know that there's a chance that they might not pull this off, and with that risk, I think there's also a sense of personal responsibility and accountability. We've had students report back to us when they realized if I didn't step up to this, this wasn't going to work out. If I didn't give feedback to my team member, he or she wasn't going to get it. And we had 2 weeks and we had to deliver. And so I think, you know, looking at the model that we're using, that final stage of bringing this learning back to campus has been really critical in terms of showing the students the value of their voice, not just outside of campus, but what they can do to positively influence our own community, because it really does start with their energy. And what's been great is over the past 4 years, as the program has grown and the students have seen, the younger students have seen these successful projects. And so this year, you know, I didn't have to do a song and dance. We had kids that, you know, in September were like, all right, I know what I think I want to do for my RISE project. And we hadn't even introduced the concept. So it's become, you know, it's infused in our community now that service learning and leadership are an opportunity. It's not about getting into college. It's not about being graded. It's not about pleasing your parents. It's about this is your chance to do something that, you know, that actually makes a difference. And more often than not, we're seeing the results that the students themselves become more transformed and are ready to lead when they have those official leadership positions in 11th and 12th grade.
Well, this is great. Service education as a vehicle for people not just to serve, but to make a difference and to lead. Kate, thank you so much for spending time explaining your program and all that you're doing.
Thanks, Ted.